In this tutorial, I'll show you how I have created this abstract art mesh in Blender. I'm using Eevee, and the scene was arranged inside of a UV sphere to block all external lights. In order for us to not to have a mesh clipping, we must have matching mesh size in its modifier settings. The mesh was created by using a torus and the array modifier with an empty object as the object offset. On the left, it's the transform values for the torus. On the right, it's the transform values for the object offset empty object. The scene was constructed by adding a think torus, and applying the changes seen on the left image. After that, an empty object, and the array modifier was added on the torus. The empty object was the array's object offset. No other settings were used on the array modifier. Here are the full nodes applied to the torus. It's the usual metallic gradient material. Please adjust the mapping nodes, X, location value to adjust the gradient on the mesh. If the original torus mesh's scale or size is not matching, we won't be able to create the same result. Here is a mesh that has the same object offset as the original, but it looks completely different. The issue was caused by the mesh's size and thickness. Both the original mesh and the new mesh are at the default world center locations. If we compare the two, we can tell the new mesh is much bigger than the old one. Even though they have the same location and the rotation values, that is. Try scaling the mesh, and we'll get a weird result each time. Let me scale the background sphere a bit. Let's try with a new torus. As we can see, the mesh looks completely different once again. Both meshes are in the same world center location, using the same object offset. This is why I feel this illusion is so special. Other people can't copy the design, because they must have a matching size and the thickness values. Do you remember how this mesh had no overlapping issues? If I scale the mesh only a tiny bit, they'll start to overlap right away. Unless we have the same values, the meshes will never look the same. This is what I wanted to show you in this tutorial. This way, we can create unique abstract art no one else can imitate, unless they have the same setting values. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.